Hello, I'm Jashykins, and just going out for a nice little walk here, you know, around the neighborhood, and I getting myself prepared for doing the Terminator review series. I'm gonna finally start it off and, you know, go and talk about my first viewing of the film, how I like the plot of it, and then pointing something out. So yeah, it's going to be fun. So hang on, I'll be getting back to my house and I'll be doing a little review, so hang on a few moments.
It is your destiny.
Fuck my destiny.
So Kazim returned my call. We'll meet about selling the Turk.
He still got it? When's the meeting?
Tomorrow morning.
Meaning this news could have waited?
You know, I haven't always been a big Terminator fan, and for people I just met, that probably surprises you. For those of you who've known me for a while, this doesn't really surprise you, because you're like, yeah, what happened? You used to be big on Star Wars. And I'd had all the soundtracks, I had action figures, I had comics, I had books, I had posters, you name it, I had it. Well, that's really a large exaggeration. But, so I was a Star Wars fan when I saw The Terminator for the first time. And when I saw it, I was like, I have to see this because I'm a big science fiction person and it's a big science fiction movie. So I saw it and honestly, I wasn't all that impressed. I just saw it as an average science fiction and action movie and really nothing else. So what's the plot to this really successful movie? Well, the plot is that Terminator is sent back in time to kill Sarah Connor, who will birth John Connor, who will be the leader of the free world. And Kyle Reese, a member of the Resistance, is also sent back from the future. But he's not out to kill Sarah Connor, he's out to do her. I mean, protect her. Protect her! And with this simple plot, it has some elements of sci-fi that I really enjoy. For one, you have the killer robot, and this Terminator takes crap from nobody. He's an unfeeling beast and just fucking awesome. I mean, now that I've seen the Terminator series, the Terminators are what I think of when I think of killer robot. And also, this involves time travel, and time travel is really an element that I really enjoy because you can just twist your head around it so much. And I love time travel. I love paradoxes. Finally, I'm going to talk about the actual Terminator idea. Now, the original idea for the Terminator was just some average smo-looking person that would walk into a place, kill a person, be revealed that, you know, it's a Terminator. And this makes really good logical sense because these Terminators are supposed to be infiltrators. No one is supposed to know they're a Terminator until they kill people. And someone like Arnold Schwarzenegger just isn't like that. And James Cameron was like, I want the Terminator to be stealthy, blah, blah, blah. But once he met Arnold Schwarzenegger, that went out the window because both him and Arnold Schwarzenegger wanted Schwarzenegger to play the title role of the Terminator. Now, cinematically, this makes a better movie because, in my opinion, Arnold Schwarzenegger was made for the role of the Terminator. I mean, I can't see another movie with him without thinking, hey, there's the Terminator! Basically, because his acting, yeah, not very good. So, it's cinematic to have him, Arnold Schwarzenegger, be the Terminator, but it just goes against all logic to have someone so obvious being a Terminator.
What
Connor, are you fucking serious? I can deal with it. No problem. Thanks for the call, and thanks for the warning, and you're cute. Bye. Okay, guys, there is no really easy way to put this. It's that... Skynet is sending a Terminator to get me. I don't know, of course, what it looks like. You know, the skins can be different. I don't know what model this afternoon. So, what I'm saying is that this review might be the last thing I do, and I might not even finish it. So, until next video, goodbye.
It irks me when I get burned and I realize I don't get hurt. And always, it seems I've lost my way. Feel you, it's not enough, and I need you. You shun my touch. I notice the season's ripe for change. Won't be the same.